What's up, guys? Corey here. I'm cleaning a concrete floor. It's not just concrete. It's basically a round, smooth pea gravel that is somehow epoxy to the floor. And I've tried several different methods. And basically what I'm doing now is I'm using two of my tools and it's become a completely orbital thing. I started out to spray the floor stripper down. And I was gonna brush it and then vacuum it away. But as soon as the moisture hits the floor, you can even pour a 5 gallon bucket out and it hides. It goes into the floor and you can't find it. So let me show you what I'm doing here and how much has been done. Just a second here. All right, this is what I've done here. And I'm using my Powerflite and I'm using my Challenger and I've got another Challenger over there. I use my vacuum to vacuum up some soil and stuff, and I've got a regular floor scrubber, which I won't use. Shop vac, won't have any use for that. And there's another Challenger around here, around the corner somewhere. But at any rate, the floor, it's a smooth, round pea gravel, and I don't know how deep it is, but you can pour out a 5 gallon bucket of water into it, and it gets lost. I don't know where it goes. So I imagine if you were to clean this floor with like a spinner, it'll tell them how much water would get lost in this place. And it's a computer store, so humidity is an issue. So basically what I've got my original helper with me, what he's doing is he's spraying right in front of me and then I'm cleaning. So you can see how different everything looks where we've cleaned and where we haven't. But it's been a learning process just to get to here, you know, and I brought a multitude of different equipment and scrubbing is not what it responds to at all. You can pour out a 5 gallon bucket of water and hit it with a scrubber before long, the floor is dry in that spot because it soaked in and went God knows where. So we're doing a VLM cleaning where you're basically misting right in front of the machine with a floor stripper and peroxide mix and then running the machine directly over it. And then we're gonna do after that is we're gonna mist vinegar over it so we'll neutralize any floor stripper that we left behind. At some point here, I'll set up the camera where you can watch some of the cleaning going on. This machine works, it tends to work better on this job because it's heavier. I think this guy weighs about 112 pounds and this one weighs about maybe about 85 pounds or so. But you know, this one orbits and spins and this one just orbits. You can use it as a floor sander as well. But this seems to be working the best. However, this is what I've got to work with here. So far I've been through, see what I've been through here. This guy. So basically about four. So math is kind of on my side. At some point I'm gonna call my wife and she's gonna come pick up a bunch of these towels. And this is what I use. This is basically a bath mat that I cut with an electric knife, basically a hot knife. So those guys go under the square machine, and looks like these guys will go under it too. The one I've got under it now is basically like this, and I don't know how it's gonna hold out, but the thicker the towel, the better. I think if I put this underneath my my big heavy machine, it will, the teeth on it will mash through it and start to grind the concrete and grind the teeth off the machine. So these guys will probably only be able to be used on the Challenger. Luckily there's two Challengers here. So anyway, I just wanted to catch the video up a little bit before I got too far, and I will be back here in a little bit to kind of show how this is going. But I told one of my subscribers this morning I didn't know how I was going to do this, but I brought everything I had at the house minus a few things, and I told him I would leave here smarter than I arrived. So I don't know who else has done this, but this is my first shot, and it was concerning when I saw it. I'd been in this store before, and I was able to name the store by the floor when they started sending pictures of it the other day. I said, I know where you're at. And they go, am I all right? And they go, yeah, you are. Yeah, this is the spot. So here I am cleaning it. I don't believe it's ever been cleaned before because it can obviously hide dirt really, really well. But the counter over there was the most soiled so far. And then there's, you can see around here, there's stuff, all this, we're gonna have to move all the stuff around today. But basically around here, all of this is gonna be heavily, heavily soiled, but the floor stripper knocks that stuff right out, and then you absorb it with a towel. So anyway, that's what I'm doing right now, and I will check back in with you guys in a little bit. Thanks for watching. Was it getting gravel under it?
No, I had sprayed it already. It's looking a little dark there.
All right, we're basically we're here. It's kind of when you mist it with a stripper, it changes colors, and then you clean it, and then here is dry, and that's clean, and we're trying to even it all out. We keep kind of improvising or changing the way we're doing things by hitting it with this, and then even follow up with this guy here behind it and make it look even better. So we're still honing the process. At some point we're gonna probably go back over that again to even that out. It looks a little darker. So at any point, I mean, we've got all the rest of this to go. So at some point I'm gonna set up the camera and just let it record while we work, so you can get an idea. But this is definitely a learning experience. I'll leave here knowing more than I wanted to know about cleaning whatever kind of floor this is. So still moving. All right, we're still, this is probably gonna be the dirtiest area. We're gonna have to do this again. This will be the dirtiest place in the whole store. There's a lot of loose gravel here. If you can imagine trying to get all of this soil out of there, but not being able to run a spinner, and plus you've got little screws and stuff in there that we're trying to get up out of our way. So it's probably the most difficult cleaning I've done. Definitely the most unique. See, there's more screws here. So we're hitting it still with a floor stripper, and we're running the power flight over it first. And then I'm running the Challenger over where we had the power flight. So it's absorbing the soil out of there. So anybody's interested in how ultrasonic cleaning or orbital pad cleaning works, it absorbs everything, you know, into the towels, and then you switch the towels out. And this is what I've got to work with over here. These are the towels that are yet to go, and those are the dirty ones there. So as this pile changes, I'm gonna have my wife come and pick up some towels so I can continue to go. Any rate, I'm gonna finish up back here and we'll take a look at that.
Shut the door, that's my wife.
Alright, we are just about half done now. They've taken everything from this side of the store and moved it over here. My helper went over this area, then I went over it a second time. You get more every time you go over it. So you can see where I've got it from the counter here, all the way here, and right here. So I'm going to spray this down with a vinegar mist, and then they're going to take everything from this side of the store over here and move it over here, and then he's gonna make the first pass and then I'll make the second pass over it. So the entire place with all the equipment I've brought, it looks like I'm doing the whole thing with Challenger. So I've got a 10-year-old Challenger and about a 6-month-old Challenger that I'm using. So we'll take a closer look at those guys here later. But anyway, that's what's doing the whole store right now. So anyway, I'll be over there next. I'm going to set up the camera here in a minute. I just put, I ordered from Challenger a brand new disc that goes on the bottom of the machine this past week. So I just put it on this one. And then the old one, it's just about to give out. If it gives out, we'll have to get the power flight back out. But the Challenger seems to be the best tool for doing what we're doing here. It's amazing. Who would have ever thought you could clean flat out gravel? A gravel floor with force stripper peroxide and a Challenger, and these particular towels are managing to hold up to it right here. This is what I'm using. It's able to take it. I can't believe, you know, I've got cotton too, but you wouldn't dare put cotton on gravel. But this stuff here is holding out. I've got a few of them in square that goes under this machine here, the Power Flight, and this guy weighs a ton. I may wind up, if his machine it gives up on him and I have to switch, we'll probably wind up using these under here to finish out the job. Running kind of low on towels here. My wife picked up a load of towels and took them home, and they've got a washer here, so we've got a few in the washer upstairs too. So that's kind of where we're at. I'm going to set up the camera here in just a second. I'm going to refill both of our chemical sprayers here, and when I do that, I'll set up the camera and we can kind of watch how the cleaning goes here, just so everybody watches it. Basically, when we get done with where Eddie's standing over there, that'll be about 3/4 of the way done. There's two bathrooms and I'm not even gonna cover because it's just plain old ceramic tile. And this will change the way I look at ceramic tile from here on out. Anyway, he's pre-spraying, and now I'm having to use the Power Flight because the Velcro is gone on the old machine. It won't hold the towel anymore, so. the guy that taught me what I learned in the beginning about carpet stretching and repair. Basically tell how much easier it is to manage the Challenger than it is the Powerflight. Powerflight is heavier, so it does, I think, it cleans a little faster because it's heavier. kind of takes on the peroxide in it. It kind of makes it take on a little bit lighter look. I've upped the amount of peroxide and pore stripper in it, in the whole thing, and it's working better. This is what holds the pad on. If you take a closer look, this guy here is what holds the pad on the bottom of the power flank. So here's where it was, grasping it with that. So this guy, this is a bath mat that is full of soil now. And this is fresh, but getting ready to go on there now. So you can only imagine how many times you can put this through the wash and still get more soil out. It's absolutely incredible how much dirt that'll hold being a bath mat and all. And I can't believe that I'm able to polish gravel with it and have it hold out like that. So kudos to whoever the hell makes microfiber bath mats. They you can't wear them out at, I don't know what RPM I'm orbiting it at, but it's a bunch. And it is holding out to floor stripper, peroxide, and a 112 pound machine, and that's just incredible. Anyway, I'm gonna do a little bit more pre-spraying here, kind of go over this a little more, and then we've got to move everything out of our own way over here. Brought fans and haven't really had to use them at all. Like I said in the beginning, if you pour out a 5-gallon bucket of water in this floor, it just soaks it up and it's gone. It's absolutely incredible. I've never seen anything like it. Anyway, we're doing it the little moisture way, so I'll be back in a bit after we move all that stuff out of the way. Kind of give you an idea of perspective what we're getting ready to cut through right now. I haven't sprayed this yet. I sprayed a little over here, so as soon as I spray it, it'll start to release and it'll look a little lighter here. But I'm gonna cut through this right now, and I don't know how many towels it's gonna take, but we're pretty much on the home stretch here, pretty much. I got here at noon and started trying to figure it out at 6:30 right now. I couldn't imagine if I was trying to do this by myself, how much fun this would have been. I had to break and run and actually get a new, let me show you what holds it on the bottom of the Challenger here. Let's see here. For anybody that doesn't know how everything connects on the bottom of the Challenger, it's Velcro basically. So this one is brand new. I just put it on there. They shipped it to me this past week. The old one gave up, and I was about holding on to about here, and the rest of it was missing. So it looks like this area is catching a little hell here. I'm ordering another couple of these this next week just to have on hand here. This guy here, yeah, it's even soaking through the back of it. All right, put this over here. And the other one, the other machine, there's just nothing left on the bottom of it. It's all gone now. So I've got that many towels that are left, and I've got some of the square ones over there. So we've got to make do. And I think they did one load of towels here, so there's a little bit more that I can source from. But we're close, really, really close. All right, I'm gonna spray all this, and then we'll get to cleaning here. All right, I just cut right through that over there. Figured I would kind of cover some of this here. This part's fun. Oh, thank you, man. I appreciate it. Basically, you can see where it's been sprayed to. You can tell how well the PowerFlite works, but you can tell how difficult it is to drive. So I've got to give it to the Challenger. It takes a little longer to clean with the Challenger, but it won't kill you like this machine. I'm letting my helper use the Challenger, and I'm using the more difficult machine because I feel like that's a nice thing to do. Thank you. forgot to move my plug, and we're gonna go over this another time after I get through with this with the Challenger to get a little more soil off it. You can see where right here, this was done once, but we're gonna do it again. Still a little, hold on, a little soil right here.
There you go.
All right, guys, this is, I think this machine is gonna change the way I clean tile. I've never used it for this before because it's so heavy, but it's amazing how it's knocking everything out of the grout line and getting everything off the tile. And we just saw it clean out here, so if we can clean off this, then cleaning non-porous tile is like taking candy from a baby as opposed to taking candy from a grizzly bear like we're doing out here. You go, hold that. Cover all of this. I just wanted to show this how amazingly well this is working. So you're going to see this machine more for when I clean tile in people's houses. All right, guys, we are all finished up now. Eddie is doing just a little bit of cleanup here, but basically as the tile starts to dry, you can see how those fingers in the microfiber towels, how they get down and grout, and they just rub everything out of there with a mixture of forest stripper and nitrogen peroxide. So it is still drying. So this was where it was just incredibly dirty in here, and it just knocked everything out of there. It's still wet, so we're getting all that right now. And neutralizing it with vinegar here. Hey, Eddie. Hey.
Yeah.
Say hey, man.
Sorry?
I told everybody hey, man.
Hello, sir.
So, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
This is Eddie. He's helped me since probably 2002 or 2003. He's the guy that taught me how to stretch carpet, and he taught me how to repair carpet. And
that would be me.
He's a wealth of carpet knowledge. When I hired him to start helping me, he knew far more than I did. I didn't know anything, but I owned a truck mount, and he basically taught me everything I know. So, many thanks, Daddy.
A little too much for it.
No, that's a true story, man. All right, guys. Now, I'm gonna throw all of this back on the van. So this guy here, after that tile cleaning I just did, this is gonna stay on the van for tile. It doesn't work very well for carpet, but it slides over tile like butter. I mean, so this guy will be used for tile from now on, and this obviously will be for carpet. And I've got two more of these guys on the way. What they've done now is they've made the it's a little like, it's thin like a door skin piece of plywood with this with the Velcro glued to it, so you just change those out. And you're supposed to use Gorilla tape, but I didn't have any, so I wrapped it very tightly with black electrical tape, and that's what finishes it and holds it over on the edge. So this guy I cleaned with from basically 2010 till this past year, when I replaced it with this guy in Challenger. So this guy is still running after all of those years. It still runs fine. It just looks like just complete death. But it was out cleaning again today. If it weren't for the, let me show you the bottom of it. I don't know if I showed that in the video earlier, but this is basically, when I used to repurpose it myself, the bottom, I would put these Velcro strips on it, and it was in, you know, I just took it off the van and retired it when I got the new one. So this is what wouldn't pull it off today. It just wouldn't do it. So, and one more thing I wanted to show everybody, if I can find it, this right here is what you can scrub tile with. It wouldn't work. I had ordered it just for today to do this for here, but this is what holds it on the bottom of the Challenger, and you scrub with this and it does an incredible job. However, this is not your typical floor, so I don't even know that people that learned what I did today and how I did it, how it would benefit them, because you never run across. This is basically a floor that goes on a garage, and if it's in a garage floor like it's generally made for, you would use the pressure washer and just hose everything out of the door. Anyway, I'm going to put all of my stuff back on the van here and head home. So, all right, guys, I appreciate you watching the video. I hope somebody out there, I hope I helped them today in some kind of way. You know, and if anybody has questions, the number is 512-350-1129. So you're welcome to text me with questions. I felt like if I worked my butt off all day, I would leave here knowing more than I did when I showed up. And that's exactly what happened. I took on a job that I didn't really know exactly how I was going to do it until I got here, and then I was going to figure it out. But special thanks to a buddy out of New Jersey. His name is Anthony. I was talking to him about it, and basically it went kind of the way he described. So thanks to Anthony, and thanks to my buddy Eddie here, and thanks to my, I believe I've probably made another client here for life, hopefully. Anyway, I've got to go. I've got to put all this stuff up, and I've got another job tomorrow. Luckily, I moved it until the afternoon so I can sleep till tomorrow morning. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. I'll see you on the next video.